Well, I knew I'd be on this show. So I wrote a little poem coming into town. It took me all day of driving to write this. But it's about, of course, the women on the ranch and how you get them there. When considering the acquisition of a mate, there is, of course, just cause to ruminate. Most folks think marriage is love, honey, and clover. You're also stuck with the old dude till hell freezes over. You may be drawn to the curve of her body, soft voice, shining hair, and liquid eyes, but I contend that what you should be scrutinizing most carefully is her size. Whilst assuming you've already examined her conformation, pedigree, temperament, and teeth, I submit the question to ask yourself, self, where's the beef? Beef, you say? Well, ain't no way. Your concept is most quizzical. But let me remind you, lest we forget, that most ranching life is physical. You wouldn't dream of hitching your good rope horse up to a draft horse job on hand, crew, but you throw all your good sense out the window when a pretty little girl smiles at you. Those petite denim darlings with the rodeo smiles are mostly bone and gristle. They ain't worth a darn for warmth and comfort when the winter wind starts to whistle. Now, on the other hand, be careful not to land one that's too large to enjoy. They're costly to feed, and when they get peed, they can slap you around like a toy. So I offer up a rule of thumb that may help you in this area. Find you a woman big enough to do the job, but not big enough to scare you.